Okay, so our first examples we talked about were hawk-dove games, and then we talked about the prisoner's dilemma game, and then another common category of game is going to be what we call a coordination game. And this is important when you often have people trying to agree on a certain set of technical standards is the most common one. So that could be in something like computing. And the example I'm going to look at is going to be, say, units of measurement. So we could go ahead and use metric, or we could use the US system of measurement. And we're going to go ahead and have, say, a tool maker. And we're going to go ahead and have builders. And the tool maker could manufacture everything in metric or in US units of measurement. And builders could go ahead and talk about building things in metric or US units of measurement. And I'm going to suppose that metric is actually superior I'm going to assume that metric is basically superior. And the way you can sort of see that is that the overall payoffs here are higher than in this square down here. But the important thing is for the two different groups to actually coordinate on what they're going to do. So the best outcome is here, the second best outcome is here, but the worst outcomes are when they choose different strategies entirely. So coordination games, again, sort of the key thing is you win by coordinating on a single strategy. But notice that there's a little bit of tension in the game I've built here, because the builders would prefer that they coordinate on US units of measurement, and the tool makers would like them to coordinate on the metric units. Now, these are both sort of efficient outcomes in the Pareto efficient sense, and they both have high total payoffs, but this one is even higher because this one gets 18 total payoff, this one gets 21. If you start here, the question is, how do you actually switch to there? Certainly the US, the builders are not going to want to switch. They're not going to want to make that switch to metric, because that would take them from payoffs of 10 down to payoffs of 9. So you can imagine that the tool makers might somehow say, okay, because we're going to gain 3 as we make this switch, we're going to go ahead and compensate you, builders. We're going to give you 1.5 of our 12. So we're going to change this, and we're going to take 10.5, because we're going to give up 1.5. And we're going to give you 1.5, so that'll give you 9.9 plus 1.5 gives you 10.5. And now they've made the metric the dominant strategy for the builders. So, and they would change this. So they're going to say, if you play metric builders, we'll give you 1.5. So switching from the inefficient equilibrium to the efficient equilibrium, you may have to try and compensate someone in addition to doing the coordination. But if it is more efficient, you'll create enough extra pie to be able to compensate them. So that's the idea of a coordination game.